Here we will show you how to perform the experiment for the determination of the gas constant R. You will need a Florence flask filled to about an inch from the top with water, a 400 milliliter beaker filled with water, and a blue bulb. Make sure that the stopper is secure on your Florence flask and attach the bulb to the tubing. Squeeze to push water from the Florence flask into the beaker and fill the tubing. Make sure you don't suck with the blue bulb, only squeeze gently to push air through. Now raise your beaker so that it puts the water level at the right level in the Florence flask as it was before. This may take a few seconds. When the water level returns to the right place, secure the hose with a pinch clamp. Now you can empty the water from your beaker. Now you will want to perform a leak test. Make sure that you use your empty Erlenmeyer flask. Don't put any peroxide before doing this step into the flask. Now release your pinch clamp, and you should see that almost no water flows from the Florence flask to the beaker. Replace the pinch clamp, and now you can weigh out your Erlenmeyer flask and add about 16 mL of hydrogen peroxide to this flask. You will then obtain a red stopper and some yeast, and add enough yeast to the stopper to just cover the top of the stopper. It doesn't have to be an exact amount, it's usually one or two scoops of yeast. Once you have added yeast to your stopper, take the stopper with yeast and your Erlenmeyer with hydrogen peroxide back into the balance room. At this point, you don't want your stopper in the flask yet. Then weigh out the Erlenmeyer with peroxide, and then add the stopper. Record both of these values in your data sheet. Then bring your stopper into the lab and use the alligator clips to lower the stopper gently into the flask containing peroxide. Set up your system so that your Erlenmeyer is attached to the Florence flask through the tubing. Remove the pinch clamp. This is very important to prevent explosions. Now shake gently to start the reaction. You will notice that water begins flowing out of the Florence flask and into your beaker immediately. You do not need to continuously shake your flask with the peroxide and yeast for the reaction to keep going. As you can see, it bubbles well on its own, but if you notice the reaction slowing down, you may give it an extra shake to keep it going. You should wait 10 minutes from the time you started shaking for the reaction to be complete. Then you can re-add your pinch clamp and use a graduated cylinder to measure out the volume of water in your beaker. Record this value in your data sheet. Make sure that you release any bubbles that are present in the Erlenmeyer so you get an accurate reading. Now you want to obtain a temperature of the room. Record this value in your data sheet as well. Disconnect your Erlenmeyer and bring it to the balance room. Obtain a mass and record this in your data sheet. This will help you determine how much oxygen was generated. You may also need to obtain a barometric pressure. The barometer is in the balance room. Just line up the needles and read the marking on the barometer. Here it's 762 millimeters of mercury.